this is hard. This is not a clear-cut choice. And I think that's worth being said. Member of
Utah. It was a tough call. That's the consensus for many members of the Minneapolis City Council as they approved a new contract for the Minneapolis Police Department. Tonight, we have team coverage on this monumental decision. Jessica Hart is covering the changes the city could see with this approval. But first, let's go to Jennifer Hoff outlining what's in the deal and why some were so reluctant to pass it. Jennifer?
Lauren, it ultimately passed 8-4. That reluctancy because some councilors admitted while the contract offers long sought after changes, they're also quite incremental, and in some cases, they're really only temporary. The contract laid out in more than 100 pages here, but some key points include more powers for the chief, like staffing flexibility and adding civilian investigators, along with a historic nearly 22% raise over 3 years, and that catapults the department to the top 5 highest paid in the state. The chief saying that's necessary to recruit officers when it's still down hundreds of them. While opponents argue the reforms that are in the contract just don't go far enough, supporters say there are other ways to accomplish accountability, including the state and federal court settlements that this department will be long under.
Pay raises without real and permanent reform does not actually lead to an increased healthy workforce.
It's a contract that will help our city. It's a contract that will help Minneapolis turn a very important corner, recognizing that you can get both change and safety.
Now, it's important to note that the council, remember, didn't have the ability to even change the contract once they got it, despite getting feedback from residents during several recent public comment sessions. But longtime councilor Andrea Jenkins said they can now take those suggestions into consideration as negotiations for now the next contract already begin next year.
Well, already thinking next year. Jennifer, thank you. Well, our team coverage continues now with Jessica Hart, who's been looking into what kind of noticeable changes there could be in Minneapolis. She's live now downtown.
Lauren, this contract is supposed to improve officer retention and hiring, and some community members believe this contract is the change the city needs. Others are more skeptical and worry it won't fix anything.
People want the best for Minneapolis. It's why Eileen Johnson is in favor of the city's new police contract.
I'm quite happy that they did approve the contract.
And why Stacy Gurian-Sherman isn't a fan.
I don't think that the city knows how to negotiate a contract.
The contract is supposed to help with officer hiring and retention, a goal Gurian-Sherman believes they won't achieve.
They offered no proof that the last contract increased retention or hiring.
She says the contract doesn't go far enough on reforms.
I think some of them are so common sense, it's absolutely head-scratching how they didn't get in. How about yearly mental health exams for officers?
Gurian-Sherman says culture is the key to retention, not money.
People do not want to come here because it's a dumpster fire.
Competitive pay is something, it's a very compelling component of why we go to a certain employer versus another.
Johnson founded 14 neighborhood safety block clubs in an effort to improve safety.
I'm hearing very much on a daily basis that people want more officers.
The Upper Midwest Law Center says the city needed this contract to be approved. In a statement, they said, quote, this new contract will help address the ongoing shortage of police officers in the city, currently down around 300 officers from the required 731 as mandated by the city charter.
We talked with the Minneapolis shop owner about this contract. He tells us he doesn't mind police officers getting a pay raise, but he wants to know how services will improve in his neighborhood in South Minneapolis. Back to you.